Hello and welcome back to Ultrasign. And Andreas, do you have something?
Yeah, I'm back into the darkness.
Oh,
the basement. Electronic weirdness. And this is a brand new release from Swedish non-binary electronic artist Lizette.
Okay.
Nice.
The new single "You Lied."
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Sometimes you. There we have it, and. Well, that was really nice. Really, really good sound over that one.
Yeah.
Really enjoyed it.
Dark.
Very dark, but not dark as in evil or.
No.
It has a dark feeling over it, of course, but it has to also have with it low tempo to do, you know, with.
It's kind of sleazy. with this tempo and the video. And,
the video, So, Lizette is the singer, or
Lizette is the artist.
Yeah, written by Lizette Nordahl. I just have to check out who they are. Lizette. Have they been around for?
They have been releasing music since 2016.
I have never heard of them, but Robert, you know about them.
Yeah, I've heard them before. I think I was introduced to them by a Swedish journalist, Fredrik Strage, has talked about them a lot in his podcast. And I totally fell in love with the, what do you call it, synth wavy and sound, where it's basically modern pop disguising itself as something that came out 3 decades ago. Really love this type of 80s sound overall, and I've not heard this new song, but I've heard some of their older songs and totally love it. It's just brilliant.
Yes, it's very good. And I actually have hard to put word in it, on it, because it feels so many things in it. It's some kind of, as Robert said, kind of poppy song with this guy in this. But it's something more, too, I think.
Yeah, I think so too. There's many layers there, but it's a nice song if you're driving
on. Yeah.
Song, but then you have the video, and then you read a bit of the artist, and there's more layers than just a pop song. But hey, there's usually that. But I really like. It's also. I'm glad to see new electronic music, Swedish especially, released that kind of just continues and pushes the edges a bit and reinventing this, not just copying this musical world somehow. So that's
cool. I'm looking off older tracks here, and it's like it's a theme almost. It's the titles: sorrow, cute, void, sober up. You know, it's like it's almost like a concept over it. If you just read it,
I agree. This a concept which is not outspoken, but I think so too. It's a very, you know, that's their way to communicate their art, their songs. And I also, like Robert said, I like the old stuff, and it was exciting. Well, old, you know, a couple of years ago. But then this new song, that's always exciting, you know, what happened. And I'm not disappointed at all.
Yeah, and I just figured out that I only spoke of the sound itself. This applies to their older stuff as well. I should mention that I have no idea what the song is about, and I have just been on top of the highest level of tears of layers, and it feels like you said that there is a lot in the video and a lot of the context, the texture in the lyrics that I don't really grasp and I don't really understand. I just love it for the ytligaste
shallow
The most on top, the sound, the what it's trying to sound like, but I don't think I understand what it's trying to say to me.
I don't know either. I think that's up to everyone what it communicates to you, but of course there's layers of stuff, but as just a you know the first impression, that's fine enough. You like it or you don't, and then you can explore or
Yeah,
not.
but well, the lyrics is quite simple, but it's very personal, you know. So it's not like simple in a simple way to read, but it's like this is my inner thoughts, and even if you just read them, it's like okay, it's nothing. But in this way of presenting it, do you say it like that? It gets so much deeper. With the sound and with the video that really was a story in itself. I really enjoyed that, and glad you played it for us.
Yeah, totally.
Me too. Thank you.
Okay, thanks. Bye.
Bye.